If you want to call yourself a hacker, you need to learn the dark art of glitching. To create our glitch effect, we're going to need some help from Photomosh.com, a free website that creates amazing glitch effects out of ordinary images and videos. Let's upload this Atomec Studios logo. I've already resized it to 480 by 360 pixels, so it properly fits the scratch screen. Let's have a look at the 27 tabs at the right side of the screen and check out some cool ways we can mess with our image. You can switch any of these effects on and off by clicking this checkbox to turn it on. Under each element, you'll find some sliders that let you tweak the speed, color, strength, and other variables in real time. For my glitch effect, I'm going to use slices, jitter, melt, wobble, bad TV, and scan lines. That's looking amazing, so we're ready to export now. Click this button to select the animated GIF format for your glitch file. Then click record to save 5 seconds of footage. Back in Scratch, let's import our unglitched image and call it default. In the costumes menu at the bottom left of your image editor, select upload costume and upload your GIF file. Scratch will automatically slice apart the animation, turning each frame into a separate costume. I have 81 costumes now. You can go ahead and delete some of these if you're worried that your project will be too big. Let's start coding. If you want some help putting this together, stick around until the end and we'll show you where to grab 2 different custom blocks that you can backpack and use in your own projects. If you want to support what we're doing on this channel, please like and subscribe so we can keep bringing you awesome Scratch tutorials. Let's start by centering our graphic at 0, 0. So to make our glitch effect work, all we need to do is tell Scratch to switch through our animation frames with a series of next costume commands. Let's start with our default graphic, pause 1 second, and then put a next costume command into a repeat loop. After our loop is done, we'll revert back to the default costume. This is looking pretty good already. To make the effect last longer, just increase the number of loops. Now, let's add some audio effects to make the glitch a little more realistic. Scratch doesn't have what we need, so I surfed over to freesound.org, a free sound effects database, and found this awesome file. Pro tip, if you're seeing this error message after importing a sound file into Scratch, it probably means your sound file is too big and Scratch is having trouble saving the file. I was already planning to cut this file into a bunch of shorter clips, so let's do that and delete the original file so we can save again. I've created 4 different audio files, so let's code Scratch to pick a random sound every time we click the green flag. Just put down a start sound block, and instead of picking a sound, let's insert a pick random block and tell it to pick a number from 1 to 4. Okay, our audio is working now, but we need it to end at the exact moment our glitch stops. We'll fix that by adding a stop all sounds block at the bottom of our code. Our glitch is working great now and is ready to use if you want to create a cool intro graphic for your Scratch account. I'd like to use this effect to interrupt another I've gone ahead and created a little story here featuring Pixel and our Mr. T Spaceman sprite. To mess around with the story, we'll need to hide our glitch graphic for a few seconds and then interrupt by having it appear on top of our story project. Let's tell our glitched logo to go to the front and hide at the start of the project. We'll move the rest of our glitch code over to a message block and tell it to start running when it receives a message called glitch. We'll need to add a show block right after the broadcast to make our animation visible, and a hide block at the end so we can resume our regular programming when the glitch is done. Try clicking the broadcast block to test your glitch in action. If you've added dialogue to your project, remember that voice balloons always go to the front, so you may have to hide your sprites or delete some lines of dialogue to avoid glitching your glitch. If you want some help getting your glitches running, head over to Atomec Studios in Scratch and check out the two custom blocks we've created for you. The first one sets up a basic effect where an image glitches and then returns to normal. Just enter a number in the bubble to control the length of the glitch. The second custom block, called Glitch Interrupt, adds code to make your glitch appear in the middle of your other projects.
I see over a liftoff. Podcast started. Roger.